Today I'm going to build a giant laser cut Bulbasaur. So first of all, I go online and I look for this Bulbasaur model on Thingiverse. It's made by Flowalistic, you should really check him out. He has a bunch of nice low polygon 3D models of Pokemon. I went with the Bulbasaur because it's one of my personal favorites and I think it's the most recognizable model of the low polygon Pokemon. I'll put up a link in the description where you can find all these models. Once I have downloaded the model, I can open it up in Autodesk's 123D Make. This is a free piece of software that allows you to convert 3D objects into 2D objects, which is exactly what we need if we want to laser cut them. So first of all, we're going to have to scale the 3D objects because we're going to make a huge Bulbasaur, but we can't make it too big because otherwise it won't be able to get out of the door anymore. So I'm dialing in a width and a height of about 1 meter and 70 centimeters, which is about 5'7". And this results in a length of 2 meters and 7 centimeters, which is about 6'9". Next up, we have to select the construction technique we want to use. In this case, it's folded panels, and this will convert every flat face of our 3D object into one single panel, which we can laser cut later on and attach back together in order to construct our giant Bulbasaur. Since this is a construction technique that is mainly used for papercraft, it won't only generate the seams we need in order to cut the panels, but it will also generate folding lines, which we don't want in this case because we will be laser cutting it out of solid wood, so we won't be able to bend it afterwards. That's why I have to select every line where I want to split the faces manually. So after I selected all my splitting lines, there were still some errors I needed to address. 123D Make seems to have a little problem when there are holes inside of a panel. So for example, with the eyes here, it automatically splits the panel into two different pieces that don't have a hole inside it. But this isn't really too big of a problem because I can still change those lines afterwards when I get the 2D drawings. Also, some of the panels are showing up red, which indicates that there is a problem with them. But this just has to do with some of the pieces being too small in order to fit all of the connecting holes inside of them, which again isn't that big of a problem because we can fix all this in the next step. So when everything is set up correctly, I can export all my drawings as a PDF. This PDF contains all the 216 pieces that we will need, and it scatters them, in this case, over 26 pages. Each page represents one sheet of plywood we need. But as you can see, 123D Make does a pretty bad job at nesting all these pieces, so I'm going to adjust it a little bit manually, so I'll probably get away with a few less sheets. For rearranging these parts and fixing some of the errors we encountered earlier, I'm going to use Inkscape. Inkscape is a free and open source vector editing program comparable to Adobe's Illustrator. Here you can see how I'm rearranging some of the parts and how I'm fixing the errors. Here I am deleting the faulty holes and replacing them with new ones. I'm not going to show you the entire process because it's a long and very boring one. But here you can see what a finished drawing looks like. I managed to squeeze all of the pieces into 17 sheets instead of 26. So now we can finally start laser cutting. There are two different colors used in the design file. The laser will cut all the blue lines, while all the red numbers will be engraved. Each piece has its own unique number, so you still know how to connect your pieces. All in all, it took me around 6 hours to cut all the pieces. Last part is connecting all these pieces back together. This was done using a bunch of zip ties. I guess there were somewhere between 500 and 600 of them in the entire design. For the most part, I could rely on the numbers on the pieces in order to connect them together, but I also had some additional help with a 3D printed model that we could use for reference, and also by checking out the model in the 123D Make software, it made it a little easier to find out which piece went where and in which orientation. Here you can see my colleague Stan helping me out. All in all, it took us 6 hours to put all the pieces together, but it probably would have cost me twice the amount of time if I had to do it all by myself. With the build almost finished, we turned off all the lights and we put a big spotlight inside, which gave this cool effect. We built this giant Bulbasaur as a showcase for our pop-up fab lab in Aalst, so that's where you'll be able to find it. And this is what it looks like sitting in front of our shop. All in all, I'm very happy with the end result, because I think it looks really cool. And I don't seem to be the only one thinking that, because it proves to be a real head-turner.